Hello, Leo, and welcome to your horoscope for the time of Sun in Aries. That is March 20th through April 20th, 2015, by Gaia Blooming. And usually at this point, I go through a whole myriad of dates, and I'm only going to do one for you right now, but if you want to see the whole myriad of them, check out the Aries overview horoscope that I did, and of course, the daily horoscopes. So, Leo, the one that really pertains to you is that Jupiter is going direct in your sign on April 8th. Jupiter has been retrograde, making us turn inward, working on that amazing heart chakra, love, creation, inner child, wonderful Leo energy. And now, come April 8th, it is time to move direct again and expand that heart-opening feeling. So, Leo, this month you are working on one of my personal favorite houses. Besides the fifth house, I love the ninth house. And you are working on the ninth house. It's the Sagittarius house. This is the house of adventure, exploration, expansion, philosophy. And it's time to expand your vision of the world. So my theme for Aries, I have a theme every month, and my theme for Aries this month is igniting the passion in my I am. And you know what's really cool is that I think one of the best ways to ignite passion, to, ignite the self, is to explore and learn things that you never knew. Things that are just like, they ping your heart. They're like, oh, I never knew that about that culture. This is your month. If you can travel or open a book about something new, try something new, something that expands your horizons. And come, April 8th with Jupiter moving direct, you're going to really feel like expanding into the world. Your heart is going to be like, yes. The Leos I know, it's been very interesting watching with Jupiter in your sign. I've been watching just so much creativity, so much creative production coming out of Leos. It's been a beautiful thing. Anyways, so it's time to follow your passion in your creativity, and your passion for expansion in your creativity. So, how can the world, exploring the world, being open to what the world has to teach you, being open to things that maybe before you were like, yeah, I don't know how I feel about that, being open to that, seeing how that shifts you and just ignites even more so your passion. Be open to it. And that being said, I don't think there's really too much more to go into right now with that. Is there? No, not really. Take the initiative, I would say that. But beyond that, I want to actually show you the cards. I'm more excited about the cards I pulled for you than I am about the actual horoscope. I pulled two of my favorite Osho cards. I pulled first, nothingness. And I love this card because nothingness is really everything potentialness. It is the card of infinite potential, infinite potentiality, which is what Sagittarius is all about, infinite possibilities. And it's just saying, my favorite thing, in every molecule in the universe, there are infinite possibilities of what could happen. This card reminds you that even in the void, even in the nothing, that's where everything comes through. And so I love this in light of the creativity that's going to be bursting forth in a new way with Jupiter moving direct and with the ninth house expansion. There's no boundaries to where you could go, so don't hold yourself back. And the other card that I really, really like with this is the Master card. And I think this really goes well with what I've been talking about a lot lately. Saturn and Sagittarius right now is reminding us to expand our awareness, expand our allowance, and to look with any problems back at ourselves. And this is what the Master card is saying. If there is an issue, look at yourself. Master yourself. Don't worry about anybody else. And I really do think that that's a place of expansion, because when you're busy looking at, what everything else is out there, you're kind of limiting yourself. You kind of end up putting up these walls. And you're like, hey, that's infinite. In here, this is where I need to focus. focus that work, focus those, focus those eyes and shift from that place, you will find the world will be your oyster. The world will open up. So, master yourself. Don't worry about the world. Let the world be your horizon and tune this back on yourself and let Jupiter and Leo open your heart as you work on yourself and master yourself. So, that's it for you this month, Leo. Have a beautiful month and check out the daily horoscopes for more information. Namaste.